un objeto común.
Okay, so here we have totally 6 formulas required to calculate the next level of problems in this module. Okay, first formula is on single payment compound amount factor. Okay, first formula is on the single payment compound amount factor. So that is F is equals to phi into bracket 1 plus I whole raised to N. This formula is applicable to find the F value when given P, okay, given P value. Okay, so this formula is applicable to find the F value when given P. Okay, and the second one is, and note on all these formulas in your book. Okay, one book, note all these formulas. Okay, these formulas are required to calculate the next 40% of portion. Okay, note all these formulas in the book. So is this slide visible to everybody? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Then note all these formulas in the book, notebook. So these are required. Okay, first one. Then second one is on single payment present worth factor. Okay, the second formula on the single payment present worth factor, this formula is required to calculate the value of P when given F. Okay, this formula is exactly reverse of first one. Okay, reverse of first one. Okay, single payment present worth factor, this formula is required to calculate the value of P when given F. Okay, so this second formula is reverse of first one. Then third one is uniform series sinking fund factor. Third formula is on uniform series sinking fund factor. This formula is required to calculate the value of A when F given. When F is given. Okay. Third formula is on the uniform series sinking fund factor. This is required to calculate the value of A when given F. Okay, here A indicates equivalent amount. Okay, A indicates equivalent amount. It means amount of invested every year. Okay, so amount of money invested in the first year, second year, third year, eighth, ninth, until 10th year, amount of money invested every year until 10th year. That is the equivalent amount here. Constant amount invested every year for a some period. Okay, that is known as equivalent amount. Okay, I will explain this equivalent amount factor in next during the time of solving the problem. Okay, just note down the formula. Okay, A is equals to F into bracket I divided by 1 plus I holders to N minus of 1. This formula is required to calculate the value of A when F is given. Okay, here A indicates equivalent amount. Okay, it means constant amount of money invested every year for a some period. Okay, for a given period. Okay, that is the equivalent amount. A indicates equivalent amount, constant equivalent amount. Okay, and fourth one is, fourth formula is on uniform series compound amount factor. This formula is the reverse of third formula, the reverse of third one. Okay, so this formula is required to find the value of F when given A. Okay, So this formula is required to calculate the value of A when given A. Okay. So this is the this fourth formula is the reverse of third formula. Okay. And the fifth one is fifth formula is on uniform series capital recovery factor. Okay, uniform series capital recovery factor, and this formula is required to calculate the value of A when given P. Okay, so this formula, this fifth formula is required to calculate the value of A when given P. Okay, given P. But third formula is also required to calculate the value of A, but given F. In third formula, difference between third formula and fifth formula, both are required to calculate the value of A only, but the third formula is applicable when given F and fifth formula is applicable when given P. Okay, in both the formula, we are going to calculate the value of A only. Okay, but the given factor will be different. Okay, in third formula, given value will be F and in fifth formula, the given value will be P. Okay, so this fifth formula is the, fifth formula. Then sixth one, the sixth formula is the reverse of fifth formula. Okay. Just interchange the numerator and denominator. You will get the sixth formula. Okay, the sixth formula is the reverse of fifth formula. Okay, what is the sixth formula is on uniform series present worth factor. So this formula, the sixth formula is applicable to find the value of P when given A. Okay, this fifth formula, sixth formula is applicable to find the value required to calculate the value of P when given A. Okay, so second formula is the reverse of first one. Then fourth formula is the reverse of third one. Then sixth formula is the reverse of fifth one. Just interchange the numerator and denominator. Okay. So please note all these formulas in the notebook. So these all six formulas are very important to calculate the next level of problems in this module. And also this CFT is the most essential thing to solve the problems. Okay, CFT and these formulas. 40% of the question depends on these concept. One on CFT, second one on formula. Okay, so CFT is very important. Just it's a graphical representation of incoming money and outgoing money. Here the incoming money is in the form of benefit and outgoing money is in the form of investment. Okay, so here in the graph we have an horizontal axis. That horizontal axis represents time frame. Okay, that time frame is divided into number of time periods. Okay. That would be in the form of months or years. Okay, and also we have some vertical lines. Okay, so it means incoming money and outgoing money, that is income and outlets, are represented by vertical lines below and above the horizontal axis. Okay, so usually, most commonly, the incomes or benefits are represented above the horizontal axis. Keep it in mind, this is very important. Incomes are represented above the horizontal axis and investments or outlets are represented below the horizontal axis. Okay, investments or outgoing money or outlets are represented below the horizontal axis, and incoming money or benefits or salvage value are represented above the horizontal axis. Okay, so this is very important. So still, anybody having any doubts on these topics? Problems on two problems on compound interest and theory on CFD and formulas required to calculate the problems on present worth factor, sorry, single payment factor or uniform series factor. If you have any doubts, then you can ask. And don't miss the class, please. I'm not going to repeat this module in physical class. So please don't miss the class. Okay, text the ISBN number. Here the, see, just only 60 participants are participating here. 60 students are attending out of 135. But I am not repeating this module in physical classes time.
रजिस्टर करता हूं ट्रेडिंग शुरू करने के लिए मुझे सिर्फ $10 जमा करने की जरूरत है
Okay, you can leave the class now. Thank you. And don't miss the class.
Thank
please.
You, sir.
Okay, please don't miss the class. I am telling repeatedly.